Good morning, all my dear student of TY BSc Physics class. In previous lecture, we have seen a stable multivibrator circuit, then working of the circuit and designing of a stable multivibrator by using IC555. We studied in previous lecture. Now, in this lecture, we are going to see the next type of multivibrator, that is monostable multivibrator by using IC555. The monostable multivibrator or circuit of monostable multivibrator is illustrated by this figure. In this figure, pin 4 and 8 is connected to positive VCC, then pin 7, that is discharge, is connected to the resistor RA, and the resistor RA is connected in between pin 7 and pin 4. Now, pin number 2 of IC555 is connected to trigger input, and this capacitor C is charging and discharging. This capacitor is charging through this RA by pin number 4 and 8, and this capacitor is discharged by threshold voltage which is connected to pin number 6. Pin number 1 is ground, and via this ground 0.01 microfarad capacitor is connected in between pin 5 and pin 1 in order to frequency compensation. Okay, this is about the circuit. Now we are going to see about monostable multivibrator. Mono means single. According to this name, the monostable multivibrator by using IC555 has one stable state. Remember that monostable means single stable state, and the multivibrator which is having single or one stable state is called monostable multivibrator. Okay, when there is a steady state condition, then it outputs is fixed. When there is a steady state, trigger is not given, or in absence of trigger signal, this circuit having steady state condition. And in this steady state condition, the output of this circuit is fixed, that is either low or high state. What I say, when there is no trigger signal, the circuit is having a steady state condition, and when there is a steady state condition, obviously the output of the circuit is fixed, either the output is either low or output is either high. Okay. Now, when circuit is triggered by trigger input supply connected at pin number 2 of the IC, trigger input is nothing but a square wave external pulse, and when this trigger input is connected, then output of this monostable multivibrator changes from low to high or high to low. What I say, when trigger is given or when circuit is triggered with an external pulse, what happen? The output of the circuit changes from low to high or vice versa. The circuit diagram of this monostable multivibrator is very important. Okay. Now, see here how this circuit works. When trigger pulse, we already studied the block diagram of this IC555 in previous lecture. There are two comparators. Lower one is comparator number 1, which is having the reference voltage level 1/3 VCC, and upper comparator, that is comparator 2, which is having the reference level 2/3 VCC. Okay. So we have to memorize that block diagram, and when you are studying this action of this circuit, then you have to follow that diagram, because according to only this diagram or this block diagram, it is not possible to study well. So then you are going to study the action of monostable multivibrator by using 555. At that time you have to consider the block diagram of IC 555. As I already told you that there are two comparator, lower comparator or comparator number 1 is having 1/3 VCC, and upper comparator, that is comparator 2, is having the reference level 2/3 VCC. Okay. Now when trigger pulse or when trigger input is less than 1/3 VCC, see here, when the trigger input level or trigger input is less than 1/3 VCC, less than 1/3 VCC, see here, what happen? The output of the comparator low, that is comparator number 2, goes high, and when goes high, output goes high, when output is goes high, what happen? That set the flip-flop output lower comparator, when what I say, when trigger input is less than 1/3 VCC, the lower comparator, output of lower comparator goes high, and it set the flip-flop, see the flip-flop in block diagram, set the flip-flop, that is Q is equal to 1. And when flip-flop is set, it discharge transistor turn off, it discharge transistor turn off, and output is high. Hence capacitor starts charging through this RA with time constant T is equal to simply RAC. Okay. This is the first part of the working. The second part, that is, this is the charging, this is about charging. I am going to repeat again, when the trigger pulse is, or trigger input is less than 1/3 VCC, is less than 1/3 VCC, at that time the lower comparator or comparator number 2 in the block diagram shows maximum output, or the output of comparator 2 goes high, and when output of the comparator, lower comparator, comparator 2 is goes high, absolutely the flip-flop is set. When flip-flop is set, the after setting the flip-flop, the discharge transistor turn off, and when discharge transistor in that block diagram turn off, the output goes high, and hence charging of capacitor starts, or capacitor starts to charging through this RA, and this charging is shown in this waveform by this charging curve. And during the charging through RA with time constant T is equal to RAC. Now voltage across capacitor reaches to threshold level, that is to this point, what happen to the, this is the 2/3 level of VCC, then output of comparator goes, comparator 1, that is upper comparator, goes high, and when output of upper comparator goes high, obviously it reset the flip-flop, and when flip-flop is reset, at that time complementary output of flip-flop, that is Q bar, is equal to 1. Okay, output Q is equal to 0 and Q bar is high. When output is low, the discharge transistor goes low, and capacitor again goes on discharging, and this discharging is shown by this discharging curve. The charging and discharging waveform, this is the charging and discharging waveform. Okay. In this waveform, the output timing T, the output timing T inter, uh, sorry, the output टाइमिंग इंटरवल ऑफ मोनोस्टेबल मल्टीवाइब्रेटर, हियर द आउटपुट टाइमिंग इंटरवल ऑफ मोनोस्टेबल मल्टीवाइब्रेटर दैट इज द टी इज नथिंग बट टी इज इक्वल टू 1.1 RAC. ओके, द मोनोस्टेबल मल्टीवाइब्रेटर जस्ट लाइक अस्टेबल मल्टीवाइब्रेटर इज कॉल्ड फ्री रनिंग मल्टीवाइब्रेटर एंड हेंस हियर वंस द ट्रिगर इज गिवन इट स्टार्ट्स वर्किंग कंटिन्यूअसली अंटिल वी डजंट रिसेट द फ्लिप फ्लॉप. सो समटाइम मोनोस्टेबल मल्टीवाइब्रेटर इज कॉल्ड वन शॉट मल्टीवाइब्रेटर. द वोल्टेज अक्रॉस कैपेसिटर दिस कैपेसिटर एट एनी टाइम इंस्टेंट इज वी इज इक्वल टू VCC इन ब्रैकेट 1 माइनस ई रेस टू माइनस टी स्मॉल टी अपॉन RA इंटू सी. दिस इज द वोल्टेज अक्रॉस द कैपेसिटर एट एनी टाइम इंस्टेंट. सपोज दिस इज इक्वेशन 1. नाउ द टाइम रिक्वायर्ड टू चार्ज द कैपेसिटर दैट इज दिस टी एंड टाइम रिक्वायर्ड टू चार्ज कैपेसिटर फ्रॉम 0 to 2/3 VCC इज कॉल्ड. रिमेंबर हियर दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू एनी टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन दैट इज मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन और आंसर इन वन सेंटेंस और क्वेश्चन इन ट्रू एंड फॉल्स फॉर्मेट एनी टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन मे बी एस्क ऑन दिस पॉइंट द टाइम रिक्वायर्ड टू चार्ज द कैपेसिटर फ्रॉम 0 to 2/3 VCC इज कॉल्ड पीरियड ऑफ आउटपुट पल्स. वॉट इज पीरियड ऑफ आउटपुट पल्स क्वेश्चन इज वॉट इज पीरियड ऑफ आउटपुट पल्स एंड आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन I am again going to repeat the question. What is the question? What is period of output pulse of monostable multivibrator? Then you have to give the answer. The time required to charge the capacitor from 0 to 2/3 VCC of monostable multivibrator is called period of output pulse. Okay. Therefore, in this equation, then T is equal to small t is equal to capital T and V is equal to 2/3 VCC. Okay, V is equal to 2/3 VCC. This equation becomes by substituting this value, 2/3 VCC is equal to VCC in bracket 1 minus e raised to that is exponential capital T. Small t is replaced by capital T upon RAC. Suppose this equation. I don't give the numbering to this equation. Now in this equation VCC and VCC getting cancelled with each other and we have only take this term toward this side and take 2/3 VCC toward this side. Therefore e raised to minus t upon RAC is equal to 1 minus 2 by 3. Just cancel this VCC with this VCC and rearranging the term. We have this term taken toward this side. Therefore, e raised to minus t upon RAC is equal to 1 minus this. And when you solve this, absolutely 3 minus 2, 1 by 3. 1 by 3. Or again solve this term. We have minus T upon RAC is equal to log for base A 1 by 3. Again solve this term. T is equal to minus RAC log for base E 1/3. Okay. And when you solve this, log natural logarithm. And in order to solve this, we have to take the log for base 10. That is, we have to multiply by 2.303 to this term. And after solving this, we will have t is equal to this one. T is equal to 1.1 RAC. This indicates that the period of output pulse depends upon RC time constant. RC time constant and does not depend on the nature of trigger pulse. Okay, I am again to repeat, this is a very important equation, which is the period of output pulse, and this period of output pulse indicates that period of output pulse depends upon time constant RC and does not depend on the nature of trigger pulse. Okay, in this way this circuit work properly. Now we are going to see the designing of monostable multivibrator. How this monostable multivibrator is designed? In order to see the designing of monostable multivibrator, see, we have to take some, or we have to assume some period. Okay, and in order to design the circuit, we are going to assume some period. Suppose we assume that the period of wave, that is t, is 0.825 seconds, and capacitor is given. Suppose capacitor, we consider the capacitor instead of this 0.01, we consider the 0.1 microfarad capacitor. Now the period of output wave, that is t is equal to 1.1 RAC. What is period? 0.825 is equal to 1.1 RA into C. 0.1 into 10 raised to minus 6 farad microfarad. 1 microfarad is equal to 0.1 10 raised to minus 6 farad. Now solve this. After solving this, that is RA is equal to 0.825 upon 1.1 into 0.1 into 10 raised to minus 6. Simply take this two value, this one and this one, toward this side. So we have this equation. When you solve this equation, you have simply RA is equal to, because here single resistor is, and in order to find out the value of that resistor, this is nothing but the designing, and the value of resistor is, say, 1.5 into 10 raised to 3 ohm. That is, RA is equal to, say, 1.5 kilo ohm. Okay. When you are going to consider 7.5 kilo ohm RA, then this circuit, it gives proper working. In this way, we studied the monostable multivibrator in detail. In next lecture, we will study the bistable multivibrator using IC555 in brief, and then we are going to solve some important problem regarding to IC555, that is regarding to a stable multivibrator and monostable multivibrator. Okay, till then we shall stop here. Have a good day. Thank you.